In this problem, we're given a heavy rope of mass M and length L hanging vertically from the ceiling of an elevator, and we've labeled the position on this rope at a distance of x from the ceiling. Now, the main idea of the problem is to compute the tension at this location of x, and we're going to do this for two different cases. First, we find the tension when the elevator is stationary. Then in part B, we turn on an upward acceleration with magnitude A, and we find the tension in that case. So we start thinking about how to find this tension, and the key point here is to just put a little cut line in the rope at a location of x. And then we realize that the tension there is responsible for holding up all the mass below that cut line. So we just have to find out how much mass lies below the cut line, but first we need the length of that little segment. So that's just going to be a length of L minus X. And just to verify that this is correct, imagine adding L minus X to X, and you arrive at a length of big L, like you should. So the mass of that little segment can be computed in a couple equivalent ways, but the most intuitive approach is to just ask, what fraction of the rope lies below the cut line? So that fraction is going to be L minus X, that's the length below the cut line, divided by the total length, L. So how much mass is below the cut line? We just take the total mass of big M and multiply by the fraction below the cut line. And I'm going to call this little m for the mass below the cut line. So that's big M, the total mass, multiplied by the fraction below the cut line. Next, we're going to put forces into our diagram. So this little section of rope has two forces on it, and those are T of X, the tension at a position of X, pulling upward on that section, and then the force of gravity pulling downward with a magnitude of little m, g. Since the rope isn't moving, these forces must balance each other out. So we can say that T of X, that upward tension on our little section, must be equal to little m, g. Now we just have to replace little m with its expression in terms of the mass of the rope and the length of the rope. And I'm going to move the g out with the big m here. So I have big m, g, which is, by the way, the total weight of the rope, multiplied by L minus X over L, that's the fraction of the rope below that cut line. Now for a general solution like this, we should be able to test our answer in some limiting cases. In other words, we can check that our solution is behaving correctly for the extremes of the problem. And one of those extremes is when X is equal to 0. When X is 0, we get T of 0 is equal to big MG times L minus 0 divided by L. Well, L minus 0 divided by L, that's just 1. So our tension reduces to just big MG if X is 0. And when we look at what this means in the diagram, if X is 0, it means we're at the very top of the rope. And so the tension there is responsible for holding up the entire mass of the rope, which has a weight of big MG. So this answer makes sense. The other extreme of the problem is when X is equal to L. When X is equal to L, we're at the very bottom of the rope, and at that point, there is no mass to hold up, so the tension should be 0. So we plug in X equals L and make sure it works. We have a tension of big MG times L minus X, which is going to be L minus L here, divided by L, and L minus L is 0, so the tension is 0 at the end of the rope. So that's working like it's supposed to. So our solution is looking pretty good. Next, we look at the case where the elevator is accelerating upward, and we've already made a small adjustment to the force diagram. If you look closely, T of X is now a longer vector than little mg, and this is because there must be a net upward force in order for our little section of rope to accelerate upward. Now we apply Newton's second law, and we'll start at the very beginning here by saying F net is equal to ma. And we're using upward as the positive direction here, so F net is going to be a positive T of X, because that points upward, minus little mg because it points downward, and that's equal to little m times a. Now solving for T of X and doing a little factoring as we go, we can write T of X as little m times the quantity g plus a. Now all we have to do is replace little m with this expression in terms of the mass and length of the rope. And when I do this, I'm going to move the g plus a toward the front. So I have m times the quantity g plus a multiplied by L minus X divided by L. So it looks like, intuitively enough, all we have to do is add the acceleration A to the acceleration of gravity to adjust our result for the tension. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, Check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.